I'm going to take the mini excavator up and get this short, fat poplar log. It's a 7-foot, 6-inch cutoff. We're going to make a few four-quarter boards. Why is it when you want a log to slide, it rolls? And when you want a log to roll, it won't. Carol about peeled the whole log before I got the backhoe part. Rolling a short, fat log onto the mill wasn't as easy as I thought it was going to be. We'll be right back. I've just about quit rolling the log 180 degrees. If you take it 90, you get to level the log at the same time and get your square corner started. It just saves me an extra roll. This thing was too heavy to level with my little car jack, so I had to use one of my ramps to pick it up. I need a hickory stick, like John from frickin' Jeep has. If you look at the log supports, you'll see that they're about the middle of the log, which I decided was close enough for leveling. We're still checking the cant for square and waves before we move on, and we're still using the sawdust bucket. It costs a little time while we're sawing, but it saves a lot of time on the cleanup. If you've been watching this video for a while now, this would probably be a good time to like and subscribe. That pop was the dreaded sound of a band breaking. So after a few minutes of fighting the blade back out of the cut and sawing off the piece of ruin, we're back to sawing. There went the board I destroyed with the chainsaw so I could get the band out of the cant. If I can remember before the cant gets too low, I like to edge against it. Thank you. I usually take a really thin trim cut after I'm finished edging in case the cant bowed up or down. Left now is for me to stack and sticker and for you to like and subscribe.